Next, I would like to talk about a topic called alternation. And the idea here is, as its name suggests, that we can alternate between ideas, or patterns. So, for instance, if we have A, and this is a vertical bar, or B, then what this pattern matches is either an A or a B. You can be longer, and you can do something like, I want to have a dog or a cat. And this bar has higher precedence, lower precedence, I guess you would say, than the straight letters. So dog happens, and then cat happens. And so you can pick back and forth between those two values right there. So any input that has dog or any input that has cat is going to match this pattern. And this is really powerful. You can combine things together with repetition or with placeholders. And basically, this is going to be the third, if you were to think of this in terms of a standard programming language, this is your selection, right? So if just a series of letters was your sequence and the repetition is your iteration, this would be like your selection. Just as an aside, regular expressions are not quite powerful enough to do any sort of program, but these three concepts have their analogs to those more powerful Turing machines. And so alternation is really powerful. It turns out that there is such a frequent way to want to be able to choose between options, but not in a full text by text, but on a character by character basis, that there is a slightly different version or take on alternation, which I will call character classes. Well, I'm not going to call it. That's what they're called in regular expressions, and they look a little bit different and they act a little bit different than alternation. So, for instance, if I want to be able to choose between three values. Let's say I can have X, Y, or Z is a possible value. If I put them in these square brackets like this, then I will match an X or a Y or a Z. With only one character, this is equivalent to X or Y or Z. And that's no big deal. But what happens is if we combine these character classes with something else. So if we do that same thing, X or Y or Z, and let's say we put a plus there, now we do X or Y or Z followed by another X or Y or Z, followed by another X or Y or Z. This is not the same as if we wanted to have a bunch of X's followed by some number of Y's, followed by some number, or not followed by, either some X's or some Y's or some Z's. Because this plus operates on the whole character class, and any one of these three for any particular character at a time will be true. So this regular expression on the right is not the same as this regular expression on the left, because character by character we can change how they match. In fact, there is no way to do a character class representation of this, because we could do the first letter X or Y or Z. But now what do we put in the second character here, character class? We don't know if we want an X or Y or Z, without knowing what we got matched on the first character. So if we put another X, Y, or Z here, then we could get in trouble because the first character that matches is a Y, and the second match character could be an X, and if we kept going, the third character that matches could be that Z right here, and that is not this alternation. We have the flexibility on a character by character basis. Let me make sure that's really clear here. That that this is where the boundary for the first character is, and this is where the boundary for the second character is, and so this character class has nothing to do with this character class, as far as choosing one of the characters in here versus one of the characters in here. Whereas up here, we do all three of these characters, or all three of these characters, or all three of these characters right here. And so you can see that character classes provide an alternative to alternation on a character by character basis rather than a full string of characters like alternation provides.